It's 15 minutes after 9. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. The fear of weight gain is one thing that keeps many people from taking on the fight to quit smoking. But researchers here in the Mid-South are on a mission to change that.
That they are. It's a study Live at 9 first told you about a year ago. Fit and Quit. Dr. Becca Krukowski is with the University of Tennessee Health Science Center. She is here this morning with participant Marlon Winter.
Good to have you.
Mr. Winter, let's start with you. What difficulties were you having at first, and where do you stand today?
Well, the biggest thing was a lot of coughing, no energy, and now I no more coughing. I work out.
You feel good?
I feel good. I can eat again.
So how much did you smoke before and for how long? Like, how big a smoker were you?
I smoked from a pack to a pack and a half to two packs a day for over 50 years.
Wow.
What about weight gain since then? Where do you stand with that? Because it seems like you don't have any issues there on the surface.
Well, I've gained a couple pounds. Mm-hmm. It's in the last couple months since I've had my last cigarette.
Yeah.
But I go to the gym to help maintain that weight.
Well, so. And actually it may be muscle weight, because if you're working out,
correct,
you may, you know, be gaining the right kind of weight. So, Becca, first of all, what usually happens typically with a smoker when they quit with regard to weight gain?
In the year after they quit, they gain 10 pounds.
Really?
Which sounds like maybe not so much, but when you kind of picture it, that's 30 bananas or 10 footballs carrying that around.
That's definitely one way to put it in perspective.
And once you start to gain weight, sometimes that snowballs. So in the second year and the third year, it might be 30 or 40 pounds.
Right. You know? My main motivation for this study is my aunt, who quit smoking back in the 70s, and she gained 40 pounds.
Wow.
And that started her struggle with weight gain.
Should that be allowed to be kind of an intimidating factor? Because a lot of folks naturally don't want to put on that additional pound, those additional pounds. But what should we do in a situation like that?
Well, always quitting smoking is better. So even if you do gain weight, quitting smoking is important.
From a health standpoint.
Yes. But ideally, there would be programs that would help you quit smoking and maintain your weight.
Which is what Fit and Quit is showing it does. How? What do you do that's different?
So we have three different conditions. The one that Marlon's in is the small changes. And so they learn how to make small changes to keep their weight stable.
Okay.
The second condition focuses on making a large change at first, losing 10 pounds to then offset the 10 pounds that they're likely to gain when they quit smoking.
Like going on a crash diet, sort of, mentally. I mean, just...
It's losing a pound or two per week, so it's not extreme, but it's not keeping things stable. It's really, you know, going down that valley so that then when they do maybe regain some weight, that they're overall stable.
Okay.
And you mentioned a third condition as well.
Right. That's a self-guided condition where it is a book and a cookbook and the same strategies, but in a self-guided way.
So how was it determined that Marlon would be best with the first, with the small changes?
So people are randomized to conditions because we
don't
know
which works better.
Right.
Gotcha. Okay, so what kind of changes are we talking about, Marlon?
Well, for me, it was smaller portions for your meals.
Okay.
And leaving a bite on your plate. Like, you know, when we were kids, we were always told we had to eat everything.
Oh, yeah.
No, this one of these parts of the program, leave a bite.
Really? Leave a bite.
And
so, Marlon, has this changed, though, your outlook on life? How do you feel these days as a whole, not just physically, but emotionally, mentally, all of the above?
It feels like I can, you know, do anything in it, you know, more than what I could do at the time. I want to live to have very ripe old age now.
That's so awesome.
And be able to do things, you know, and not be hampered by not being able to breathe or no energy.
So you have much more energy. You have your life back. Isn't that awesome? And within 5 years, your lungs will be all back to normal, right? Isn't that what?
Yep.
No.
All right. Doctor, thank you very much. Marlon, thank you as well. Leave that bite on the table.
Leave the bite on the table.
Even next Thursday.
That's it.
So the Great American Smokeout is this Thursday. It might be a good chance for you to get involved with
Thank you both.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Good to see you.